Yo, what's up everybody? Professor V here, and in this short video, I'll discuss what psychology is. Let's go. Psychology is about people, and there is a wide variety of ways to approach this field of science. It's complex, complicated, and definitely not foolproof. To put it into easy terms, there is nothing simple about people, but it is not just about individual people, but how we all interact with one another and how each of these interactions impacts us. So let's start with the top, with the definition of psychology. The widely accepted definition of psychology is a scientific study of behavior and cognition. Between these two parts, behavior and cognition, it covers every aspect of the entire human experience. Behaviors are outward, observable, and measurable behaviors in which a person performs, from a range of walking and talking, crying, sleeping, eating, hitting, basically anything that anyone else can see you do. Cognition is sometimes referred to as mental processes, or sometimes the mind. These are your thoughts, emotions, attitudes, memories, reasoning, language, perception, personality, brain functioning, and other unobservable, hard to measure processes. You see, psychology is considered a science rather than a pseudoscience because it uses a rigorous but systematic scientific method. We cannot study the mind and behavior in the same way that biological scientists study cells and atoms. Thus, the scientific method within psychology relies on human behaviors and to test theories about how the mind operates. What makes psychology not a pseudoscience is the use of the scientific method. You may have learned about it in your natural science classes, biology, chemistry, geology, etc. The scientific method consists of 6 steps. Number 1, observation and literature review, in which you form a question based on observed behaviors and research other published data pertaining to your question. Relating to your question is not the same as answers your question. Keep that in mind. Number 2, forming a testable hypothesis based on your research of published data. What is the prediction to the outcome of your research question? You may have heard the phrase educated guess to refer to a hypothesis. That is because you are looking at previously published data that supports your suggestion of the possible outcome. A guess is just forming a suggestion out of common sense or knowledge, which is often biased or wrong. Number 3, research design. In order to test your hypothesis, you must plan out how you will do so. There are several methods a researcher can use. Experimental, in which variables are manipulated to determine cause and effect. Descriptive research is when observations are made, surveys and interviews are conducted, case studies are investigated, or archival research or previously gathered data is studied. And lastly, correlational research, in which determine relationships, but not cause and effect. Number 4, data collection and analysis. Once you perform your research, collect your data and analyze and determine your findings to either support or not support your hypothesis. Number 5, publication. The researcher then publishes a paper on their findings. The paper is submitted to a peer-reviewed scientific journal, and the research is critically evaluated by other expert researchers. And lastly, number 6, theory development. After publication of the research and other related research, scientists then form a theory or revise an existing theory of the topic. This is how knowledge grows and how other researchers expand on the knowledge. Now, what I just did was briefly, very briefly, cover the scientific method. And this is what separates psychology from pseudoscience. The American Psychological Association Dictionary of Psychology defines pseudoscience as a system of theories and methods that has some resemblance to a genuine science, but that cannot be considered such. Some examples of pseudoscience include, but are not limited to, are, let's say, astrology, numerology, esoteric magic, ESP, or ancient aliens. Just because something is pseudoscience doesn't mean it isn't interesting or fun. Just know that there is no science behind these topics. Also, just because there are TV shows that portray these topics in certain ways does not mean that the scientific method is used or even can be used for these topics. As you can see in the slide, there is very little control, if any at all, over variables or experimental conditions to study these topics. A good way to discern between science and pseudoscience is looking for falsifiability. Karl Popper, in his 1934 book, The Logic of Scientific Discovery, described falsifiability as when a theory can have the capacity to be tested and possibly be proven false. For example, if a theory suggests that all drivers slow down when they see a yellow traffic light in anticipation of the light turning red, can easily be refuted and proven false through observations. However, because of the alignment of the moon and the stars influencing your behavior, cannot be scientifically tested using the scientific method or proven false. Pseudoscience seeks confirmation of beliefs while science seeks falsifiability. So, when performing any scientific research, remember to have skepticism. That is, consider carefully, which in turn allows for curiosity and open-minded approaches to knowledge. Be objective, meaning remain unbiased and look for reliability, and be rational. It is easy to get lost in our hopes and dreams and even pseudoscience, but be sure to use logical and reason over opinions and emotions. And this concludes this short introduction to psychology and the scientific method. Thank you for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. So until then, I hope you hit the like button and subscribe if not already, but until then, take care.